Hello, amazing people. Welcome to today's tutorial. Imagine saying goodbye to stubborn bedbugs and cockroaches once and for all. Sound impossible, right? Well, in this video, I'm going to reveal a powerful and simple magic insect killer recipe that works like a charm. Not only will it save your home, but I will also share some secret tips at the end of the day that make it work permanently. So make sure you watch till the very end. As usual, grab your paper and jotter and let's get started. First thing first, always protect yourself and make sure you make your production in a well-ventilated environment. Don't forget your spatula and your mixing bowl. The first ingredient goes into my mixing bowl is my tessapon. Tessapon, I'll be using just 50 grams. Tessapon acts as a wetting agent, allowing the insecticide to spread out more effectively on the insect surface rather than building up. The next chemical I'll be adding is DDVP. DDVP, you can make use of any DDVP of your choice and we'll be using 100 ml. Always protect yourself in dealing with chemicals like this and keep it away from the reach of the children or pets. I added my DDVP 100 ml into the tessapon and I stir. DDVP is a fast acting contact and fumigant insecticide that kills insects by affecting their nervous system. In insecticide production, it is often combined with water and other solvents to enhance its spread and effectiveness. And I continue stirring it until both chemicals combined together. And the next ingredient I'll be adding is industrial camphor. Industrial camphor, I'll be using 50 grams. I added it into the mixture, then I stir it together. Camphor has a strong smell that naturally repels mosquitoes, cockroaches, bedbugs, ants, and other insects. It also works as both a repellent, that is, keep insects away, and a mild insecticide, that is, weaken or kill some pests on contact. Continue stirring until it dissolves completely and mix together with other ingredients. At this point, like this video, comment and share. And if you have not subscribed to this channel, what are you waiting for? Hit the subscribe button and turn on your notification bell. Then the next ingredient I'm adding is water. Clean water, 1 liter. I gently added my clean water, then I continue stirring it. You can see the reaction of all the chemicals. You can see it whitish now. Please kindly follow it the way you see me doing my own. Don't do it otherwise in order to get it perfectly. Then the next ingredient is IPA. IPA, I use 1 liter also. You can get all these ingredients where they are selling soap chemicals. You can get all the ingredients there. Just write it down, take your list and your measurements to them, and they will measure it for you. All this place that you are buying your liquid soap, bar soap ingredients, they are still the same people selling all these insecticide chemicals. Then I added my IPA and I continue stirring it. IPA, isopropylene alcohol, is a solvent. It helps dissolve ingredients like camphor and other active ingredients, so they can mix evenly in the insecticide solution. IPA is a quick drying agent. It evaporates fast, allowing insecticide spray to dry quickly on surface without leaving heavy residue. It also improves storage stability. It helps prevent microbial growth in the insecticide solution, keeping the product stable for longer shelf life.
And the next ingredient is formalin.
Formalin can boost the strength of insecticide formulation by keeping them fresh and active. It also helps the insect to dry instantly as it gets in contact. I use 100 ml of formalin.
Kindly comment, like, and share this video.
Then you continue stirring it until all the ingredients blend together.
At this point, your insecticide should look like water, colorless and not cloudy. It's the mixing bowl that makes it look cloudy. It's not cloudy but look exactly like water. All the chemicals in this production is toxic and irritating. Kindly handle it with care. And don't forget to keep it away from the reach of the children or your pets. The next ingredient we are adding is color. Color, you can add color to your taste, and color is also optional. You can choose to add color or leave it just like that.
And if you are adding color, make sure it's water soluble color, not oil soluble. Don't add too much color to your insecticide in order not to be staining the surface you are spraying into. That is why I make sure I mix my color separate before adding it into it, in order to control the color not to be too much while adding the color into the insecticide. So as I add my color also, I'll make sure I mix it together for it to blend perfectly well.
To use the insecticide, do not spray and remain inside with it. As soon as you spray it to your room, kitchen or the affected places, kindly lock it up for some times before coming back into it. The insecticide is very effective, but you have to use it wisely. If you are using it on your bed bugs, maybe you are using it for bed bugs, as you apply it to the affected places, sun dry it to eliminate it permanently. Repeat it 3 to 4 times to get rid of it permanently.
Remember, I also added perfume to it, which is fragrance. I use fragrance, tall meal, and I stir it together. Here is my packaging bottle. I'll be packing it inside this bottle. Use my funnel to package it. I hope you have learned something in today's tutorial. If so, give this video a thumb up, like, comment, and share this video. Don't forget to turn on your notification bell. Thanks for watching. See you in the next tutorial. Bye.